Good morning, and welcome to the Keene Morning Show. I'm Sydney Key.
And I'm Harlan Bell. Today is Monday, October 3rd, and it is a day one.
On Saturday, Keene High hosted our homecoming. The morning featured the parade of floats designed by the class councils and performances by the marching band. This year's float contest featured designs on the elements. The winning class was the seniors, followed by the juniors in second, and the sophomores in last. The freshmen technically came in fourth, but they didn't actually have a float to show. Congratulations to all.
The Key Club will have their first introductory meetings before school in the LGIA on Monday, October 3rd and 17th. The meeting will be used to determine the time and place of all future meetings. Stop in between 8 and 8:30 to say hello.
The Guidance Department is hosting a college financial aid night on October 17th at 6 o'clock p.m. Please drop by to hear more about the college financial aid process.
And the 2023 yearbooks are on sale now. The cost is $65 if you purchase yours before October 28th. See the KHS yearbook section of the school's website or see Mrs. Moylan if you have any questions.
The math team will be having an informational meeting on Wednesday, October 12th during ag time. Email Mr. Tebow or Ms. Taft for more information to get signed up.
And now Dan and Austin will give us an update on Keene High sports from this past week.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Daniel Smith.
And I'm Austin Lincoln. Here is what happened last week in the world of Keene High sports.
We'll start with the homecoming game, which took place on Saturday afternoon. Sadly, Keene High lost to Merrimack 38-7. Also, Peyton Gowell, a sophomore classman, got an interception in the end zone.
Here's the sports recap from last week. The Keene High girls cross country team finished fourth out of 27 schools throughout New England at the Manchester Invitational on Saturday, September 24th. Keene faced some of the best teams from Vermont, Rhode Island, and New Hampshire, including 15 of their New Hampshire Division I rivals. The Blackbirds were led by senior Reagan Hoy and freshman Allie Ferris and Lily Runes. Also racing well for Keene High were Ella Hoy, Corinne Kinson, Lillian Hansen, and Jillian Frank.
Girls soccer played against Combow, unfortunately lost 2-1, but put up a hard fight in the end.
The JV girls took home a 3-0 win against Combow.
Varsity field hockey won 7-0 at Manchester Memorial High on Monday.
The JV field hockey team won 3-0 against Brattleboro on Thursday.
Boys varsity soccer lost 2-1 in OT against Bedford, but they didn't go down without a fight.
Unfortunately, the varsity girls volleyball team lost 0-3 against Nashua South.
JV girls volleyball also sadly lost 0-3 to Nashua South.
On Wednesday, girls varsity lost 0-6 to Lebanon.
But the bass fishing team defended the 2021 championship again. Aiden Doyon and Connor Harbrook were able to take home the 2022 championship, securing the spot at number one once again.
The Powder Puff seniors won again against the juniors. The seniors' undefeated reputation goes on for another year.
Thank you for joining us this morning, and now back to Sydney and Harlan.
Thanks, Dan and Austin. Before we go, we would like to let you know about an exciting fundraising event coming at the end of the month. Mr. Patterson and Mr. Barry, two of Keene High's most beloved staff, have challenged each other to a hot wing challenge. The details are still being worked out, but proceeds raised from this event will be going to help the senior class. Stay tuned for more details.
If you are a member of a club or have any KHS-related news you would like to have appear on the show, please contact Mr. Olson at molson@sau29.org. Thank you and have a marvelous week, Keen High.